स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू एंटर इनटू इंटरेस्टिंग टॉपिक इज केमिकल इक्वेशंस। केमिकल इक्वेशंस इट इज वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग टॉपिक। स्टूडेंट्स, वी ऑब्जर्व सो मेनी चेंजेस अराउंड अस, सो मेनी, सम ऑफ देम आर केमिकल चेंजेस टू, बट वी डोंट नो। For example, first one, milk turns into curd. This one also chemical change. Next, rusting of iron. Third one, tarnishing of copper utensils means in copper utensils or copper bowls or copper pots, upon that we will observe blue color spots that are tarnishing. Next, raw rice to cooked rice. Next, one of the best example, burning of candle. Next, in some specific festivals like Diwali, on that day we will fire crackers. Do you feel enjoy with that crackers? Yes, we will enjoy on that day. While burning that cracker, they turn into ash color. These are examples of chemical changes. Burning of crackers. So, these chemical changes generally denoted by chemical equations. That is, in words, suppose rusting of iron plus water plus oxygen means iron reacts with water and oxygen, means when iron is exposed to humid atmosphere, water and oxygen which is around to that iron utensil or iron rod, they combine together and means they undergo chemical change and forms rusted iron we will get. So in shortest form, in words means we will get lengthy, but in shortest form using formulas we will write in another form. Iron means its symbol Fe, water means H2O, oxygen means O2, gives rise to means they combine together and form rusted iron formula Fe2O3.5H2O. Next, one of the best example, burning of wood. In wood, carbon will be present. That carbon will react with oxygen, means C carbon plus oxygen, it will forms CO2. Next, in the above reactions, means in the all reactions, the left side substances are reactants, and the right side which are formed, these are known as products. Reactants, products. This process will be denoted by this arrow mark. The left of the arrow mark are known as reactants. More there means reactants. Right side means products. In this reaction, one product only formed. Next, we can get more information from this equation. We will get more information about chemical equations by using the following characteristics. Following characteristics of reactants and products. That's I will mention. First one, physical state. Physical state. Second one, heat changes. Heat changes. Next, gas evolved. In that reaction, some gases will be liberated. That gas evolved. Next, precipitate. Precipitate. This one also one kind of the product. Precipitate in shortest form PPT. Next, fifth one, catalyst. Catalyst and temperature. In some equations, temperature and pressure. Pressure also needed. So first one, we will go for first one, physical state. First one, physical state. In physical state, you have already learnt in 9th class chapter, matter around us. So all matters exist, whatever. There are three types. One is matter. Three types. One is solid. Next, liquid. Third one, gas. Any matter will exist in three states. Any matter, they may exist three states. One is solid, second one liquid, third one gas. So in the above the equations, like above equations, if any substance, they may be solid, means solid can be indicated. Solid state indicated by solid. In first letter solid, which one? S, na? S. So solid state indicated by S. Solid state can be indicated by S letter, means S is the first letter of the solid. In solid word, first letter. Next, liquid state indicated by small l. Continuously, gaseous state also indicated by G. If any substance that is dissolved in water, that will be compulsory in liquid state. So that liquid state will be known as aqueous solution. So that aqueous solution also indicated by AQ. AQ. So next. So before that, liquid state. Suppose you have any doubts upon this. So burning of wood. I already showed you wood. C plus O2 gives rise to CO2. When will we give a small fire to wood, means it will give more heat when react with oxygen. Carbon reacts with oxygen and forms CO2 gas. So here wood solid state, small s, oxygen gaseous state compulsory G, CO2 it is liquid state or solid state? Gaseous state G, CO2 obviously gaseous state. Next, second one, we will go for second one, heat changes. Second one, heat changes. In heat changes, there are two types of changes there. One is exothermic. Second one, endothermic. Exothermic, endothermic. So simply endothermic means in any equation, endothermic in any equation, it will be gained. In this, it will be gained. Endothermic means it gained. That in that equation, it if it will be gained means that is endothermic. Suppose in any equation, it will be liberated. Energy will be released. That is exothermic. It released. That is exothermic. Simple words. So exothermic, you know so many examples. We can take above example also. Carbon. Yes, see. Carbon reacts with oxygen. Means when we fire carbon, means wood. When we fire wood, it will react with oxygen and it will give more heat. More heat. So more heat. This heat here liberated. In this reaction, heat is liberated. So this reaction is known as exothermic. So there are two examples. One is already we know, carbon reacts with oxygen. CO2 will be formed. Heat. Here heat is indicated with Q letter. Indicated with Q. Plus Q. Here plus Q means energy released. Plus indicates releasing of energy. Releasing of energy. Plus Q indicates releasing of energy. Next, second, this one first example, second one, this one an exothermic. Exothermic. Next, endothermic. Endothermic. Endothermic means when nitrogen gas, G, carbon solid, oxygen gas, CO2 also gas. Here nitrogen gas plus reacts with oxygen gas gives rise to nitrous oxide NO. Nitrous oxide NO minus Q. In first equation plus Q. In second equation minus Q. Minus Q indicates gaining of energy. Gaining of energy. So in second equation, it is absorbed. Suppose